Hi, I'm Mr. Eck.
I'm Bradford.
And I'm Heather.
And today we're going to talk about solving a trig word problem.
The population of coyotes in a canyon over a certain length of time is given by the function C of t equals 20 sine 30t plus 50, where t represents the time in months, and C of t represents the population of coyotes.
So, the first thing we did to solve this problem was use the B value, which is 30, and use that to divide 360 by 30. And we found the period, which was 12, using that. And so, the midline on the graph would be 50 because the C value of the equation is also 50. And to find the amplitude, you would look at the A value, which is 20, in the beginning of the equation before sine. And since the amplitude is 20, the maximum on the graph would be 70, and the minimum on the graph would be 30.
Alright, so problem one is find the population of coyotes after exactly 7.3 months have passed. Then, find the next time that the population will reach this exact number. So, we know the equation is C of t equals 20 sine times 30t plus 50. And we can figure out how many coyotes the population of them after exactly 7.3 months through this equation. By plugging in, we know that t is the months, and so we can say C of t equals 20 sine 30, and then times 7.3, because it's 7.3 months, plus 50. And so we can rewrite it, we can say C of 7.3 equals 20 sine 30 times 7.3 plus 50. If you do this out in your calculator, you should get about 37.41 coyotes. And fractional coyotes are okay for now. Now, to find the point at which the coyote population is exactly the same at the nearest next point, it's actually pretty simple. As you can see, 7.3 months would be somewhere right around here on the x-axis for the months. And so if you're going to find the next one, all you have to do is you look for the next point on the midline. So this point right here is 6, and you can see that 7.3 is 1.3 months after 6. So to find the equivalent point over here, what you would do is you would say, okay, so it's 12 here, and then you do 12 minus 1.3, which would get you 10.7. And those two are at the exact same height. So it would be the same coyote population here as it would there, and it is the nearest point at which it would occur again.
The second problem says to find the length of time that the population is more than 60 coyotes. The problem also says it would like a sketch of the graph, which we already have. So on the graph, you should probably make a line where 60 coyotes would be, and we've already done that here. And the problem wants us to find the length of time in which there will be 60 coyotes. So, you know, we're going to have a point here because it's 60 coyotes then, and a point here because it's 60 coyotes then as well. And we're trying to find the time in between those points. This is the equation that we should use to solve the problem. Because we're using 60 coyotes and trying to find the time in which there are 60 coyotes, we're going to have 60 replace our C, because C represents coyotes. And so 60 equals 20 sine 30t plus 50. I solve the equation and the solution is 1. Feel free to pause the video now and take a look at the steps. But if you really don't understand how to solve the equation, you should go look at the other videos on this channel. So, the point where t equals 1 would be the first point where the number of coyotes is 0. So, this first point. We're trying to find the length of time in between where there are 60 coyotes. So we also need to know this point right here. Now, because 1 is 1 away from 0, and this point right here where the graph touches the midline again is 6, we're going to want to subtract 1 from 6, which would make this 0.5. See, because, you know, 0 plus 1 equals 1, that's 60, and 6 minus 1 equals 5. And so, 5 minus 1 is 4. And that is the length of time in between where there are 60 coyotes.
Thank you for watching. Goodbye.
Bye.